Patricia Callahan is an investigative reporter who has shared Pulitzer Prizes in two categories at two newspapers. Her stories have led to substantial policy changes that have improved the lives of children. Callahan came to Medill in 1989. She lived in Willard and aimed to be a narrative nonfiction writer like Joan Didion. And then she took an investigative journalism class, where she learned how to use public records and detailed reporting to uncover important stories. She put those skills into practice during her senior year when she interned at the Chicago Tribune. She wrote a front-page story about children falling from public housing high-rises. As a result of Callahan's story, the Chicago Housing Authority installed thousands of window guards across the city, saving the lives of countless children. Callahan was hooked on journalism. After graduation, she became Medill's first Henry Luce Fellow. She worked in Thailand investigating the trafficking of children for prostitution. After a brief junior reporting fellowship back at the Tribune, she joined the staff of the Denver Post. She was one of the first reporters to arrive at Columbine High School on the day of the 1999 massacre. Her stories helped the paper win a Pulitzer Prize for breaking news. Callahan spent a few years reporting for the Wall Street Journal before returning to her hometown of Chicago and to the Tribune. In 2007, she and a team of Tribune reporters investigated botched recalls and lax enforcement of children product safety laws. The series led to the recall of more than 1 million toys, car seats, and cribs. Illinois Congressman Bobby Rush took her stories to Congress. Rush led an overhaul of the Consumer Product Safety Commission, and Callahan shared a Pulitzer for investigative reporting. Callahan was a finalist for two more Pulitzers, one about ineffective and toxic flame retardants. It also won a Goldsmith Prize and was featured in a documentary called Merchants of Doubt. And the other one was about people with disabilities who were being abused and neglected in Chicago group homes. No matter the story, Callahan continues to use the method she learned at Medill to gather records, ask critical questions, and write stories that matter to her hometown, Chicago. She says she can't imagine doing anything else.